This is episode 154 of Dad Awesome, and today is the last day of the year 2020. So it's New Year's Eve. Happy New Year's. Some of you are listening after this New Year's Eve, so you're into 2021, but that's okay. We thought we'd just take a moment as a ministry to say thank you. We just wanted to start by saying thank you. I am so grateful for each of you taking time to listen or watch. We're both on YouTube, and we're on all the podcast platforms from Spotify to Apple Podcasts to all the other ones. We are so thankful that you've taken intentional time in the past and today to say, I want to grow as a dad. I want to add life to the dad life. I want my kids to experience a dad who's saying, I'm intentional. I'm not trying to survive the dad life. I'm pressing in and turning the dials of intentionality up around my fatherhood. So thank you for being that dad. Thank you for being Dad Awesome. As a ministry, we wanted to take time to just share with you guys, why does Dad Awesome exist? So kind of the why Dad Awesome? What are some highlights in the year 2020? Where is this ministry going in 2021? And then finally, how can you be a part of accelerating this mission, furthering this mission, reaching more dads? So just ways you can get involved and be more a part of the team at Dad Awesome. So this is a little different episode, but praying that this is helpful. And I wanted to just set things up with a Bible verse. This are a couple verses out of Proverbs chapter 24. It says this. This is verse 3. Wise people are builders. They build families, businesses, and communities. Through intelligence and insight, their enterprises are established and endure. Because of their skilled leadership, the hearts of people are filled with the treasures of wisdom and the pleasures of spiritual wealth. And this is verse 5. Wisdom can make anyone into a mighty warrior, and revelation knowledge increases strength. So these are some things I want for my little girls. And I've got 3 little girls and a 4th little girl on the way. And my prayers for them, I pray that their hearts are filled with the treasures of wisdom. I want them to be young women, women who grow up and are just, their hearts are filled with the treasures of wisdom. I want them to experience the pleasures of spiritual wealth. I want them to be mighty warriors, difference makers, change makers for the kingdom of heaven here on earth. I want them to affect their neighborhoods, their communities, their businesses, their families, as it says in verse 3. I want them to have increased strength. So these are all the promises attached to, it starts at this point, it starts with verse 3, wise people are builders. They build families, businesses, communities. So it talks about intentionality and it talks about building. And the vision and mission, why Dad Awesome? The reason we exist is we want to see a generation of dads who are builders, who are saying with intentionality and focus, with their time, with their money, with their passions, I'm going to build a family. I'm going to build towards having a heart connection with my kids. I'm going to build in a direction that glorifies the Lord, in a direction that my girls, or in your case, if you have boys, my kids, my sons, my daughters are proud of a dad who's building something of significance. So again, wise dads are builders. So instead of wise people, wise dads are builders. They build families, communities. Another thing that wise dads build, and a little bit of the way I'm going to paint a picture of the vision for why Dad Awesome, is wise dads build rope swings. Now, let me expand on this. I believe there is a ripple effect to building a great rope swing, and there is a ripple effect to not experiencing a great rope swing. So I'm going to hit both sides with our vision and mission at Dad Awesome. Now, a great rope swing takes a tree and takes a rope. It takes a little bit of intentionality. So we have a tree in our front yard here at our house, and by throwing a rope up and over a branch and securing it to some kind of anchor point, the trunk of the tree or another tree, we can create very quickly, very easily, a rope swing experience in our front yard that causes cars to slow down when they pass. It causes kids, it's magnetic. It causes kids to come flocking from other homes. It causes parents to stop their walks and to join us. That rope swing causes my daughter's eyes to shine, giggles and shouts of joy. It causes actually moments where we teach our kids about lining up and waiting their turn and cheering for each other. The rope swing has a contagious ripple effect of joy, of laughter, of shiny eyes, of community. The rope swing moment of just a little bit of intentionality from a dad. Again, it also can cause harm. So you got to be careful as a dad. It takes a intentionality to create a safe rope swing. Often we just tie a loop on the bottom of it, put your foot in. That's fine. Or for little kids, you can clip on a baby swing. You can clip onto it. You can clip on a normal swing from a swing set so you can sit in it. You can clip on all kinds of attachments, but basically you just need a rope and a tree and an intentional dad or parent or older sibling, but in my case, it's a dad. The rope swing ripple effect brings lots of good, lots of joy, lots of community, lots of stories to be told. The rope swing ripple effect causes great good if you create a rope swing. Now, on the other side, without a rope swing, kids that grow up without a rope swing don't get to experience the joy-filled flight of swinging on a rope. Those kids don't get to experience the training that comes with starting slow and low and moving to higher heights and bigger trees and thicker ropes, and they don't get to experience that. They don't get to experience the joy and the courage and the fun and the cheering of other kids. They don't get to experience the waiting in line that comes with a rope swing. They don't get to experience a dad or other parents or neighbors cheering for them. The lack of a rope swing actually has a ripple effect to losing out on a lot of delight and joy and a lot of being celebrated. Like, not having a rope swing can actually bring a lack and harm and loss. And the reason I set this up, and maybe I'm going a little too far into the rope swing analogy, but I believe in the same way dadAWESOME exists to bring a positive ripple effect, just like a good rope swing. dadAWESOME exists to bring shiny eyes to that dad, kids that realize I have a dad who loves being my dad. dadAWESOME exists to give cheerleading. We're going to cheer for you. To give resourcing, to give ideas and encouragement and tools to help you be dadAWESOME for your family. dadAWESOME exists to have a ripple effect of a dad who loves being a dad who's trying to connect with, who's pressing in and saying, man, my heart is turned towards my kids. I'm choosing life. I'm choosing to add life to my kids. I'm choosing to spend one-on-one time. I'm choosing to come home a little bit early. dadAWESOME has a ripple effect that goes to our families, to our neighborhoods, to our kids' kids. It says in Deuteronomy chapter 30 that you can choose life or death, blessings or curses. But if you choose life, you and your kids, your descendants may live. It's a ripple effect forward. There is a ripple effect of positivity to an intentional dad. So we exist as a ministry to create resources, to create cheerleading around you being dadAWESOME, you adding life to the dad life. So it's a resource and encouragement around intentional fatherhood. Now, let's talk about the negative. We talked about the lack of a rope swing can cause all these things to not exist for a kid. Well, the lack of intentional fatherhood brings massive harm. We have so many just heart-wrenching statistics that we know about. We know that one of the greatest ills, the greatest epidemics in society globally is the lack of dads. Just in the United States, there's 18.3 million children, about one in four kids, that grow up without a biological dad, a stepdad, or an adoptive father in the home, about one in four. And those kids have a four times greater chance of ending up in great poverty. They have a twice the chance of infant risk. So these kids without dads, of infant mortality. They have a much higher likelihood of incarceration. They have a seven times more likely to become pregnant if they're a girl as a teenager. Seven times they grow up without a dad. These kids are twice as likely to have childhood obesity. And these kids, again, that grow up without a dad present in the home are twice as likely to drop out of high school. And there's dozens more heart-wrenching statistics that go along with fatherlessness. So the second side of dadAWESOME and reason we exist is we believe that dads connected with the heart of our Heavenly Father, dads whose hearts break for the fatherless, are more intentional dads. So there are already kids that have grown up without a dad, one in four, who are in a place of, they have not experienced fathering, and dadAWESOME exists, again, to have a ripple effect to those dads as well, or those kids as well, the kids without dads. And that's the rope swing analogy of growing up without a rope swing. We have created a ministry called Fathers for the Fatherless. We mobilize dads to do something hard, to bike 100 miles for kids without dads. Now, is it always direct mentorship? No. Some of these dads end up doing foster care or adoption. Some of these dads serve the fatherless directly. But our ministry exists to awaken passion, awaken awareness around dads to the cause of the fatherless. Fathers for the Fatherless, it brings dads to a place of their heartbreaking for kids without dads, and then that comes full circle to them going home and they're way more intentional dads. So we're focusing on being intentional dads, but we're also focusing on connecting with the heart of our Heavenly Father around the heartbreaking situation of so many kids that don't have a dad on the home front, a dad who's intentional with them. So Dad Awesome exists to lessen and care for and resource with finances and with prayer the cause of the fatherless. And it exists to turn up all these dials of intentionality for dads and their kids so that we are Dad Awesome for our kids. So these are the two sides of our vision and mission is we want to be intentional dads, but we also want to step in and be dads who are caring for, again, kids without dads. So that is the two sides of the vision. That is why Dad Awesome exists. Let's talk a little bit about some highlights from the year 2020. So some highlights from the year 2020. We did have a chance to build this ministry further this year. So January 2020, Dad Awesome podcast celebrated 2 years. So we're almost at the 3-year mark now, but our 2-year celebration, we had about 25,000 downloads of the podcast this year. March 2020, we launched YouTube. So all the podcasts now are on YouTube as well as in your podcast apps and in your earbuds. So we launched that and we had about 3,000 views on our YouTube channel this year. April 2020, we created Dad Awesome Foundations. So we created a 4-part framework called Life. So I am loved, I am free, or I'm sorry, I'm loved, I am intentional, I am free, I am engaged. A 4-part process. It was on Thursday nights on Zoom. We had 93 dads join us for one of our cohorts of Dad Awesome Foundations. And again, adding life to the dad life framework. So we did a curriculum and we saw this many dads, 93 dads be a part of that. In August 2020, Fathers for the Fatherless, the bike ride expanded to 64 dads biking 100 miles and we raised $104,000. For the fatherless. So grateful. All that money went to two of our partner ministries that serve the fatherless directly. And then in October of 2020, I stepped into full-time fatherhood ministry with Dad Awesome. So I stepped after 7 years of being on staff as a pastor at Substance Church, I stepped into full-time ministry for the fatherless, very much supported by my local church. But I took the leap into full-time ministry. So those are the 5 highlights from the year 2020. Now let's talk about where is this ministry going? So where is Dad Awesome headed this next year? And I'm going to take us back again to Proverbs 24 because we are building a ministry and we believe that the same principles that apply to dads being builders apply to this ministry being built. So it says this, Proverbs 24, 3-5, wise people are builders. They build families, businesses, and communities. And through intelligence and insight, their enterprises are established and endure. Because of skilled leadership, the hearts of people are filled with the treasures of wisdom and the pleasures of spiritual wealth. Wisdom can make anyone into a mighty warrior. Revelation knowledge increases strength. Our prayer as a ministry is that we would be helping dads be builders, but that we would build a ministry, you know, based with skilled leadership and that we would have the treasures of wisdom and we'd have the pleasures of spiritual wealth and that there would be intelligence and insight that would lead to us equipping mighty warriors for the kingdom. Dads who are mighty warriors, raising up kids who are mighty warriors, and there'd be increased strength in all these families. So many, and in the show notes, this passage, these 3 verses, and this is the Passion Translation of Proverbs 24, 3-5. So we have 5 goals for this upcoming year as a ministry. I want to share them with you guys now. So 5 goals, we'll hit them kind of fast here, but we have a goal. The first one is to grow our prayer team. We have a prayer team to 150 people praying for this ministry. That could be monthly, daily, weekly, twice a month. My prayer is to have 10 people every single day praying for this ministry, for you listeners, praying for the guests that we interview, that they're just be a prayer covering that would be so thick. This ministry would be just guided. We pray for cloud, pillar of fire by night, cloud by day, pillar of cloud by day. Man, we have that kind of clarity on where to take this ministry forward. The second goal for this next year for 2021 is Team Awesome. So this is I call it Team Awesome, but our team of people that give financially to this ministry. So we're set up as a 501c3 through our partner ministry venture. We're praying for 75 people to give either monthly or one-time gift, just 75 people to say, I'm with you financially to help seed capital, build this, plant this ministry, see this ministry grow forward. And so we're praying for 75 total people this year to give financially to this mission. The third goal for this year is that the podcast would multiply by a factor of 10 times so that we would go from 25,000 downloads this last year to 250,000. 1,000 downloads. So a 10x growth for the podcast. The fourth goal is that our YouTube channel would multiply by a factor of 100 times, 100x. So our prayer is that we would go from 3,000 video views to 300,000 video views. That these are both full podcasts, but also that we really get intentional with short, practical ways that we can grow our intentionality as dads. And we know that YouTube is the second greatest search engine, so it's video content for dads to help them be more intentional and be dad awesome. So 100 times growth there. And then the fifth goal for this year is that our Fathers for the Fatherless ride would multiply by a factor of 10, that we would 10x our Fathers for the Fatherless. We would equip 640 dads to ride 100 miles. This will be both in the Twin Cities and about 10 other cities across the country. And our prayers that we'd raise $1 million for the fatherless this year. Those are our five goals for this year. So some of you might be asking, man, how can I help? I want to help build this ministry, and I'm grateful. I'm grateful that you're asking. And here are some ways that you can help us build this ministry forward, reach more dads. You can join us. Man, we'd love to have you join us. And by joining us, you can listen to the podcast. You can watch on YouTube those clips. You can ride your bike 100 miles in one of these rides, or you can run. We're going to do a Father's Day run here in the Twin Cities. You can run a 100-mile relay run. So most dads are going to run 12 and a half miles. So join us. That's the first one. Share. And this is all in the show notes. Share. Dad awesome. Share. Every share can lead to more dads being impacted by this ministry. So you create a resource, and the prayer is that it's helpful enough that people share it. So by sharing, you can subscribe on YouTube, subscribe on your podcast app. You can share and you can review, write a review. That really helps, especially with Apple Podcast and Spotify. So the third way that you can help build and further this ministry is you can pray. Our prayer team, again, the prayer is to get 150 people on the prayer team. We'd love for you to join that. There's a link right in the show notes to join our prayer team. But you can pray for us. That'd be massively helpful. The fourth way you can help kind of build this ministry is you can give. Our prayer is to be an enterprising ministry, a ministry that has economic engines built in that will sustain growth for the future. But the first few years are going to take a team of people that say, I want to give seed capital, I want to give startup funds to get this ministry going to that place of being financially sustainable. So we are praying for, again, 75 people to join that team, Team Awesome, and make a financial gift. And we are thankful. Substance Church and Venture Expeditions, these two ministries have given already a huge base for us to move this ministry forward. But we are praying again for 75 people to join us. And then the last way that you can help is you can be an inviter. You can just personally invite through a text message, invite five other dads through a phone call, through an email, just through face-to-face, just say, hey, have you heard of this ministry? By inviting personally and just giving them dadawesome.org, the website, or the link to your podcast app or the YouTube channel. That would be hugely helpful, and we're so grateful. So again, you can join us, you can share, you can pray, you can give, you can invite. Those are ways you can help. Our prayer, my prayer for you, here we are, New Year's Eve, the last day of 2020. My prayer for you is that you would be a dad who is a builder. So I'm going to pray this over you guys, Proverbs 24, 3 through 5. God, I pray that each of us listening, that we would be wise, that we would be dads who are builders, that we would build our families, build our businesses, build our communities. God, I pray for intelligence and insight, that through intelligence and insight, God, that each of these dads listening, that they would experience their enterprises being established and endure. God, the work of their hands would be established and endure. I pray in Jesus' name for skilled leadership on the home front. God, give us the skills we need to connect with the hearts of our kids. God, we pray that that skilled leadership would lead to hearts of people, hearts of our kids, hearts of our wives, to be filled with the treasures of wisdom and the pleasures of spiritual wealth. And God, I pray that wisdom would turn our kids into mighty warriors, and that revelation knowledge would increase the strength of our kids and us as dads and our families. God, I pray the blessings of this Proverbs, Proverbs 24, 3 through 5, over everyone listening. God, I am thankful that you are not done doing a work in our hearts as dads, that you want to set us free, you want to equip us, you want to fill us with your passion to see this dad role as the most important role. So I pray in Jesus' name for a new wave of joy around fatherhood, a new wave of intentionality, and a new wave of fun. God, I pray that we'd be dads that would just have so much fun as we lead our families. God, I pray that just life, like life in abundance, Lord, would fill our families and they would experience a dad who truly loves being their dad. God, thank you for these moments of listening. Thank you for everyone listening. And I pray you'd fill them with joy in Jesus' name. Amen.